chapter 8, okay, which we are going to continue, okay, under the topic of database, okay. And for this particular topic, okay, chapter 8, we will go in depth on the value of information, okay, under decision making process. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, so basically, okay, last week we did more on the function of databases, okay, and type of database, okay, and also the function of data warehouse, okay. And as for today, we will go in depth more toward the value of information under decision making process. Okay, so right here, we will get to know about the system organization, okay, used to make decision. So we will utilize the database that we develop, okay, and we use it, okay, for the purpose of decision making. Okay, describe the three quantitative model typically used by decision support system. Okay, this is one of the term, okay, one of the popular question for the test decision support system. We have three quantitative models. Kita akan go one by one. Okay, describe the relationship between digital dashboard, okay, the function of this particular digital dashboard, okay, towards this particular EIS, okay, and some of the AI, artificial intelligence, okay, and also data mining. And what we have here under this particular decision making. First thing first, okay, how to value the information, okay. Before this, we get to know about the data, okay, and we also get to know about the information, okay. And right here, okay, we actually value that particular information toward the decision making process. Okay, so reason for growth of decision making information system, as you can see right here, people need to analyze, okay, large amount of information. Okay, we have a very mass numbers of information, so we need to analyze. Okay, so that's why from that particular information, okay, we try to sort out, okay, and try to value, and only we take, okay, the important things, okay, of the information for our decision making. Okay, we have innovation in communication, globalization, okay, when making a decision or appraising an opportunity. Okay, and nowadays we have to make decision very quickly, okay, because this particular decision making, okay, most of the company need to do it in spontane, okay. Okay, secara spontan kena terus buat keputusan impromptu. Okay, very prompt decision. So, how to fit this particular decision? Okay, information that we receive from the database. Okay, time is for the essence of people simply do not have time to sift through all the information manually. Okay, so we have to be quick, okay, in making decision. Okay, people must apply sophisticated analysis technique. We have comprehensive technique, okay, such as modeling, forecasting, to make a good decision. And this particular system will help you, okay, in making decision making nowadays. Okay, and people must protect the corporate asset of organizational information. Okay, so basically, what we have here, okay, the employee, okay, the employee and the employer, they have to utilize the information that received through database, okay, to protect their corporate asset. Okay, so information system offer the security required to ensure organizational information remain safe. Okay, basically under this particular database, we have certain protection, okay, like password, okay, you need to subscribe, login, sort of that. Okay, and right here, we will go in depth into a model of decision making. Okay, first thing first, we have to know what is actually model. Okay, model is a simplified representation or abstraction reality, okay, which can calculate risk, okay, understand uncertainty, change variable, and manipulate time. Okay, so this is the what we so call as the general definition of model. Okay, it actually simplified representation or abstraction of reality. Okay, and under this particular chapters, okay, we will go under these three model. Okay, first we will go towards the bottom one. Okay, transaction processing systems. Okay, TPS. Okay, the second one, decision support system, DSS. Okay, which actually under managers level. Okay, and executive information system. Okay, for the top one, for the senior executive level. Okay, transaction processing system. Okay, only being done by the operation level. Okay, or we so called as the analyst. Okay. Okay, moving up to the organization pyramid, user move from requiring transactional information to analytical information. We have to go from the bottom to the top one. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, most of the information that you key in, all being done by the operational level, or we so-called as analyst. Okay, that one is under transactional level, okay, which you are actually dealing with this kind of fine data. Okay, and that one is under online transaction processing. We will go after this, what is actually online transaction processing. Okay, next one, we will go further, okay, for the intermediate level, or so called as managers, which dealing with some of the process, okay, type of data is more toward, granular, okay. So this is what we have under what we so called as the system or model itself, okay, and the top one is the executive. Okay, so executive will deal with analytical approach, okay, which the data is a big cost, okay, and usually, okay, they will execute, okay, the data that they receive from the managers. Okay, so this is what we have under transaction processing system. Okay, so transaction processing system, okay, the bottom one, okay, is, okay, the basic business system that serve the operational level in an organization. Okay, so when it come to basic, okay, it deal with key in data, okay, more toward updating the data, okay, all being deep under this particular level, okay, the bottom one, okay, analyst. Okay, and as you can see, okay, they have two terms. Okay, first is online transaction processing, the second one is online analytical processing or OLAP. Okay, so this online transaction processing is the bottom one. Okay, when you deal with this particular key in, okay, key in the system, okay, key in the system, update the system. Okay, that one is under the bottom one. Okay, and all being done under this particular what we so called as analyst people, okay, or operational people. Okay, they will present information and update existing information, store information and update the existing information. Okay, who actually manipulate the data, manipulate the information, sorry, okay, manipulate the information, okay, the person, okay, that actually hold the executive position. Okay, that one is under the top position. Okay, and next one, okay, this particular decision support system. Okay, so decision support system usually being used by the managers. Okay, managerial level. Okay, so this model information to support managers and business professional during decision making process. So they are actually being fed by the operation level. Okay, so this particular analyst will feed the data to the managers. Okay, manager will make decision, okay, based on the information given under this particular decision support system. Okay, so they will process, okay, to make decision for their business. Okay, that is what we have under decision support system, usually being used by the managers. Okay, who actually feed the data? The operational level. Okay, And three quantitative model used by DSS, okay, we have this three quantitative model. When it comes to quantitative, mean it can be measurable. Okay, maksudnya dia boleh diukur. Okay, boleh dikira. Okay, what we have here, okay, we go for sensitivity analysis, okay, which the study of the impact that are changes in one or more parts of the model have on the other part of the model. Okay, so this particular sensitivity analysis, it's more towards, okay, when impact to one department, it will affect to the other department. Okay, itu adalah kita panggil sensitivity analysis. Maksudnya, we are actually study on the impact. Okay, kesan kepada department yang lain. Okay, kesan kepada our products. Okay, so this is what we so called sensitivity analysis. Okay, what if analysis pula. Okay, so what we have under what if analysis, check the impact of a change in an assumption of the, on the proposed solution. Okay, so what if analysis is more towards you are actually using, okay, the information, okay, given. Okay, so you propose a solution and then you actually think, okay, what is the after effects? Okay, so this is under what if analysis. Okay, compared to sensitivity analysis, dia lebih kepada the consequences. Okay, the impact or the consequences of the others department if you take the solution. Okay, and next one, goal seeking analysis, find the input necessary to achieve a goal such as a desired level of output. Okay, so this goal seeking, okay, it's more towards objective base. Okay, so you can find out, okay, the necessary input to achieve a goal. Okay, so usually, okay, if you want to solve a problem, okay, you are looking for this particular sensitivity analysis and what if analysis. Okay, and if you are going to achieve or obtain your particular company goals, it fall under goal seeking analysis. Okay, so manager will make decision based on this particular three type of models. Okay, under decision support system. Okay, and as you can see right here, okay, usually for the operational wise, okay, ataupun analyst, okay, analyst dia akan dealing dengan transaction processing system. Okay, like here example, we have order entry data, inventory data, shipping data. Okay, so dekat sini the analyst, okay, or the IT officers, they will enter data, dia akan key in data, okay, to the system, okay, to the database. Okay, same goes to inventory, okay, and shipping data. Okay, so all the data will be put under one system. Okay, like from this particular order data, dia ada dalam order processing system. Okay, inventory data, all stock, ada dalam inventory tracking system. Okay, and shipping ada dekat distribution system. So all can be considered as database. Okay, who actually use this particular data yang akan buat decision? Sebab this particular stage, okay, is more towards what we so call as operation, okay, or operational level. Okay, so middle level, managerial level, they will use this particular data to make decision. Okay, so it being pulled to sales data, manufacturing data, and transportation data, which all being accumulate under decision support system. Okay, and they will make a decision based on all this particular database. Okay, so they akan form into one managerial reports. Okay, so like here, like you can see, transaction process system supply transaction based data to decision support system. This support system will summarize and aggregate. Okay, so they will sort actually the information from the many different TPS system which assist manager in making informed decision. So decision making made by the manager's level. Okay, and how about the senior executive? okay, so senior executive, they will adopt or they will apply this particular executive information system. Okay, so top position people, they will use this particular support system named executive information system. Okay, as you can see right here, specialized that support senior level executive within the organization. Okay, usually the what we so call as the chairman, okay, not chairman, sorry, the CEO, okay, the CFO, okay, COO, okay, so chief executive officers, this is the person that will look, okay, all the data, okay, under this particular system. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, EIS offering the following capabilities. Okay, consolidation. Okay, what is consolidate? They will incorporating. Okay, they will collect all the data under one simple report. Okay, so this is what being viewed by the executive information system. Okay, features simple rollups to complex grouping of interrelated information. Okay, and it also being viewed under drill down, okay, which enable user to get details and detail of details of the information. Okay, all should be viewed by the top level. Okay, and slice and dice. Okay, yang this actually the concept under the data warehouse. Okay, that we have learned last week. Okay, slice and dice, look at information from different perspective. Okay, because this particular level, okay, the top level, they are actually dealing, okay, dealing with what? Dealing with the direction of the companies. Okay, compared to managers, they will solve problem. Okay, analysts more toward operational base. Okay, but executive here, the senior executive, okay, the senior executive here, the top people, okay, they are actually the one that decide, okay, the direction of the companies, okay. And as you can see right here, okay, the executive information system, okay, they have an extra view, okay, extra view compared to the decision support system. Okay, here is decision support system. Okay, they only can view inside of the company, internal. Okay, executive information system, you add up this particular external source of information. Okay, that's why only top people will decide the direction of the companies. Okay, whether to maintain their product, okay, whether to upgrade, okay, whether to shift their product to the other levels. Okay, that one is all being done under executive information system. So you can get to know about the, okay, example, the industry information. Okay, how about the stock market going up or going down nowadays? Okay, industry outlook and market outlook, which will be compiled under this particular executive report. Okay, and then they will decide, okay, whether to maintain or to make a new what we so call as direction for the companies. Okay, so what would you need interaction between the TPS and EIS? Okay, EIS need information, okay, from the TPS to help executive make decision. Okay, so this particular details that being entered, okay, by the analyst, okay, being used by the EIS, okay, to make a decision. Without knowing all the information, inventory information and shipping information from TPS, it would be very difficult for the CEOs. That's why I said just now, okay, this particular executive management system will be viewed by the CEOs, okay, and the other top level, okay, CFO, COO, okay, to make strategic decision for the organization. The direction of the companies, okay, will be done under this level, okay, exactly, because the managers, okay, managers only solve problem, okay, but the director, okay, which namely the CEO, COO, and numbers of the senior executive level, they are actually the one that make a strategic decision, or we so-called as the direction of the companies. Okay. And what actually being viewed, okay, by this particular executive information system, okay, being viewed by the CEOs, okay, so they viewed under digital dashboard. Okay, this particular digital dashboard, okay, integrate information from multiple components and present it in a unified display. Okay, sort like infographic. Okay, so the assignment that I have instruct you to do, okay, infographic, it will summarize. Okay, summarize of what? Okay, summarize of the performance of the companies. Okay, this one is more toward under digital dashboard. Okay, so it will show. Okay, the budget. Okay, the cost. Okay, which actually contribute. Okay, under this particular company. Okay, the expenses of that. Okay, so it is easier. More executive can perform their own analysis without in under IT personnel with queries and requests for report. Okay, so they can do it by themselves. Okay, without okay asking IT personnel to do all this kind of thing. Okay, so digital dashboard, whether basic or comprehensive, deliver result quickly because we actually get the gist, okay, party of the information ataupun the basic or the key information, okay, receive quickly. Okay, we can look whether the company is gain some profit or receive loss. Okay, you can see from this particular digital dashboard. Quicker employees have information, the quicker they can respond to problem, threat, and opportunities. Okay. And how about AI? Okay. Artificial intelligence. Okay. This particular artificial intelligence, okay, actually simulate human intelligence, such as the ability to reason and learn. Okay. So usually, okay, this is the technology, okay, which simulate. What is actually simulate? More toward the word of simulation. Okay, means that they are actually this particular system. Okay, they act like human. Okay, so the system. Okay, use this particular have the ability to act like a human. That's why they so called as artificial intelligence. Okay, so the ultimate goal of AI is the ability to build a system that can mimic a human intelligence. Okay, usually we use this kind of robot. Okay, but the thing that installed under this robot, the system itself, okay, which actually use, okay, or we so call it as adopt, okay, the AI concept. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, the robot that at the airport, okay, which actually alert passenger to security and non-smoking room while it scrubs, okay, the floor, okay, or the terminal, okay, of the airport. Yeah, so this is actually we use the AI, okay, they give this kind of alert, okay, to the passengers. Okay, four most common categories of this artificial intelligence, okay, we have four categories. Okay, the first one is expert system. Okay, what is expert system? Computerized advisory program that initiate the reasoning process, okay, of expert in solving difficult problem. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, usually this expert system, okay, it being portrayed, okay, under help and support. Okay, they actually can imagine what you are going to ask. Okay, so this one is more to the expert system. Okay, human experience is transferred to the expert system and user can access the expert system for specific advice. Okay, like under Asia. Okay, under Asia, we have this particular what we so called as pop-up. Okay, they actually will answer, okay, based on the script. Okay, that they forecast, okay, what actually being tried to ask by the audience, okay, or the website visitors. Okay, Most expert systems contain information from many human experts and can therefore perform a better analysis than any single human. Okay, so they are actually compiling all the queries, okay, from the experts. Okay, and next one is neural network. Okay, what is actually neural network? Okay, neural network, basically we use under this particular machine, like washing machine. Okay, and this particular what we so call as neural network, okay, is we apply under electronic products, okay, which actually attempt to emulate the way the human brain works. Okay, this kind of fuzzy logic, okay, a magical method of handling imprecise or subjective information, okay, is under this neural network, okay, which most useful for decision that involve pattern or image recognition. Okay, so this particular neural network, okay, they actually make decision based on the pattern or image recognition, okay, from the users. Okay, as you can see right here, typically used in finance industry to discover credit card fraud, okay, by analyzing individual spending behavior. Okay, so under this particular finance industry, okay, they actually adapt this particular artificial intelligence, okay, to discover this credit card fraud. Okay, they will know the pattern. Okay, usually being fraud under what amount of money. So they will see the pattern, okay, from the case. Okay, so they also can analyze individual spending behavior. Okay, like most of the fraud, okay, is usually a fall, okay, for the customer that spend under maybe for air ticket, okay, using credit card for the air ticket, okay, or maybe for the groceries. Okay, so this is some of the pattern, okay, being analyzed, okay, being analyzed, okay, under this particular neural network. Okay, and as you can see, the basic one, okay, usually like this kind of fuzzy logic, okay, yang biasa guna adalah memang washing machine. Okay, we have aircon. Okay, yang mana kalau misalnya dah sampai satu tahap, contoh you set temperature 25 degrees. Okay, so dia automatically akan terus go for that particular temperature. Same goes to washing machine. Okay, so washing machine, okay, you put your what is so called as baju dekat dalam mesin, okay, dia boleh detect, okay, the weight, okay, of that particular baju yang you nak basuh, and then berapa masa yang akan diambil. Okay, yang itu kita panggil fuzzy logic. Sebab dia based on logic. Lagi berat, lagi lama lah. You kena habiskan masa untuk basuh. Okay, kalau baju setakat selai dua lai, dia akan take fewer times. Okay, so that one is the basic of this particular neural network. Okay, which the the base one is the fuzzy logic. Okay, next one. As you can see, okay, use genetic algorithm. Okay, this genetic algorithm is more to programming, okay, artificial intelligence system that mimics the evolution, survival of the fittest process to generate increasing better solution to a problem. Okay, so genetic algorithm belong to the larger class. Okay, biasanya genetic ni kita biasa associate dengan DNA. Okay, which generate solution to optimization problem using technique inspired by natural evolution such as inheritance, okay, mutation, selection and crossover. Okay, as you can see right here, okay, they can detect, okay, they can detect the portrait of Mona Lisa. Okay, or what we so call as usually yang used nowadays lebih kepada, okay, how to detect, okay, the face of the Pharaoh ataupun Fir'aun. Okay, daripada mumia tu kita boleh detect. Okay, they use this kind of thing. Okay, genetic algorithm. Okay, so end of the proses, you boleh nampak macam mana rupa sebenar yang yang kita boleh what we so call as kita boleh dapat, okay, untuk that from that particular mummies, okay. That one is genetic algorithm. Okay, it will appear the projected face, okay, based on the algorithm. Okay, and last one, okay, is motor intelligent agent. Okay, special purpose knowledge based on information system that accomplish specific tasks on behalf of its user. Okay, so when it come to agents, okay, it is representative. Okay, can learn the type of competitor information users want to track, continuously scan the web for it and alert user when significant event occurs. Okay, so this is what we have under the last AI. Okay, mean they actually copy, okay, they actually copy the act, okay, of the original users. Okay, that's why they got the intelligent agent that can learn the type of computer information users want to track. Okay, continuously scan for the web for it. Means that this particular intelligent agent, okay, contohlah kalau misalnya you dah key in, okay, dekat hotel, okay, you key in, you nak book hotel semua sekali, okay, next time, okay, this particular what we so call as internet website, okay, website, dia dah boleh tahu dah, dia boleh tackle what you're going to book. Okay, dia akan copy apa sebenarnya yang you punya trend yang you pernah buat semua sekali. Okay, and they will appear into the same order. Okay, that's why kat sini dia lebih kepada imitation. Okay, ataupun dia copy. Okay, from the original users. Okay. And next one, data mining. Okay, what we have on data mining? Okay, data mining ni banyak kepada what we can be said as the customer relationship management. Okay, it's a technique used to divide information set into mutually exclusive group such the member of each group are close together as possible to one another and the different group are as far apart as possible. Okay, so they actually used to divide information set. Maksudnya dekat sini, bila kita masuk pada cluster, dia akan kelompokkan mengikut a unique identity. Okay, kalau misalnya this particular members, okay, is alike ataupun sama, dia akan masuk dalam group yang sama. Okay, itu yang kita panggil clustering, kelompokkan dia. Okay, so depend on cluster analysis to segment customer information and identify behavioral traits. Okay, sebab tu I mention tadi, this particular customer relationship management system depend on cluster analysis. Yang mana contohlah this particular CRM, okay, dia nak kelompokkan, okay, the most what we call as good buyers. Okay, maksudnya pembeli yang bagus ni, setiap kali dia go for the website, okay, dia akan beli barang. So akan dia kelompokkan satu. And then bila dalam tu juga, dia akan kelompokkan lagi. Is it grocery saja ataupun clothing? Okay, mengikut type of products, okay, and type of transaction. Okay, so this is what we have under data mining. Okay, they will segregate, okay, they will sort, okay, into certain type of group. Okay, and we also have this kind of association detection. Okay, what is association detection? Kalau macam tadi, this particular cluster analysis, dia akan split up, dia akan bezakan, dia akan groupkan. Okay, association detection, dia akan cari relationship. Okay, maksudnya dekat sini, dia akan cuba cari kaitan. Kalau tadi lebih kepada perbezaan, okay, sebab tu dia kelompokkan. Okay, association detection lebih kepada mencari kaitan antara data. Okay, and then digroupkan. Okay, so this relationship in the information, okay, such as market basket analysis, okay, which analyze as website and checkup, okay, scanning information, okay, to customer buying behavior. Okay, next one is statistical analysis. Okay, this statistical analysis perform, okay, perform what? statistical test. Okay, we have correlation, distribution, calculation and variant analysis. Ini lebih kepada measurement. Okay, maksudnya untuk test the hypothesis, okay, untuk buat this kind of simple interpretation of the data, okay, through testing method. Sebab this particular statistical analysis lebih kepada testing, dia menguji data tu. Okay, dia nak test data tu, adakah valid tak valid ke, adakah ada hubungan ke, adakah ada different ke. So we use this kind of statistical analysis. Okay, sebab tu kalau tengok dekat sini lebih pada measurement. Okay, measurement of the data. Okay, so what we can do, okay, under forecast. Kita boleh buat forecast bawah statistical analysis. Okay, we predict, okay, based on the trend. Okay, tengok kepada trend pengguna. Okay, kerana kita boleh buat projection. Okay, forecasting. Maksudnya kita boleh buat this kind of jangkaan. Kalau contoh kita produce TV, adakah this particular type of TV, okay, dia punya kuantitinya bertambah atau sepatutnya kena berkurang, okay, untuk being produced by the company. Okay, so that one is for the forecast system. Time series information. Okay, what is time series information? Time series information collected at a particular frequency. Maksudnya dekat time series ni, dia akan ada a list of time. Okay, contoh yearly, monthly basis, daily, hourly. Okay, so it depend on the requirement of the companies. Okay, so time series information, okay, will be used. Contohlah, you nak buat pasal the analysis of the sales, okay, of the company daripada day 1 sampai day 30, tu daily basis lah. Okay, kalau you nak tengok the whole view, macro view, mungkin you buat secara yearly. Tengok 5 tahun ke belakang. 5 tahun ke belakang ada tak peningkatan ke penurunan? How about the trend of the sales? That one is under time series information. Okay, so that's end our chapter. So kita akan revise balik. Okay, so define the system organization to use to make decision and gain competitive advantage. Okay, so dekat sini bila kata define the system je, automatic. Okay, we get to know about the top three. Okay, transaction, decision and executive information system. Okay, so this particular three system, they actually will shape. Okay, will shape what? Will shape the information. Okay, the use of information for decision making. Okay, we also have AI. Okay, artificial intelligence. Ini ada 4 dekat bawah, AI and data mining. Okay, so describe the relationship between digital dashboard. Digital dashboard ni digunakan automatic oleh executive. Okay, so top management. So a special DSS, okay, that support senior level executive. Bila nampak senior level executive je, automatic itu adalah CEO. Okay, ataupun board of directors. Okay. So within the organization, okay, the dashboard integrate information from multiple component and present it in a unified display. Senang cerita, dia sebenarnya di kita dashboard ni dia akan summarize. Okay, so kita boleh view in a simple way. Okay, sebab tu contohnya adalah macam infografik lah sekarang. Okay, so you can make what we so called as not assumption, but lebih kepada decision, okay, sebab direction, okay, based on that particular views, okay. List and describe 4 type of artificial intelligence, okay, yang kita ada expert system, kita ada neural networks, okay, generative algorithm dengan intelligent agent, okay, ini semua I dah explain tadi, and 3 type of data mining analysis. Okay, we have cluster. Cluster ada lebih kepada perbezaan. Okay, you akan grupkan mengikut perbezaan. Okay, association, you akan looking for relationship, kaitan antara data ataupun information. Okay, statistical analysis, bila you nak test, bila you nak ukur, you want to measure, you use statistical analysis. Okay, and that's all for chapter 8. Okay, any question? one equation. So kalau tak ada, any question for the assignment, individual assignment, dah start buat? Infographics. Okay, make sure only one page saja infographic. Infographic dia tak ada multiple pages. Okay, you only have to summarize. Okay, macam yang I minta tu, under daripada empat tu, you pilih satu. Okay, and try to do it under infographics. Okay, ada tengok how you actually relate dengan companies. Okay, that adapt that particular. That particular what we so call as system, okay? Okay, kalau guna poster platform, boleh ke tak? Okay, boleh, tapi dengan syarat you have to save it under PDF. Okay, sama juga yang PowerPoint pun dia kena save dalam PDF. Okay. Sebab kalau misalnya you tak save dekat dalam PDF, takut I punya PowerPoint version lain, you punya PowerPoint version lain, dia akan ubah dia punya setting. Okay, maksudnya kalau you dah draw under that particular infographic, okay, some of the format mungkin tak boleh dibaca mengikut this particular PowerPoint. Okay, so please save your assignment dekat PDF. Sorry. Sebab I suruh PowerPoint kena ada voice kan? Memang kena PowerPoint lah kot. Okay. So PowerPoint yang boleh guna adalah PowerPoint yang di latest one lah. Sorry. Kalau misalnya kata projection untuk yang poster tadi memang tak boleh lah. Sebab dia nak dikira sebagai presentation sebenarnya for this particular infographic. So nak tak nak memang kena guna PowerPoint di latest one. Okay. Sorry yang pasal yang the poster platform tu automatic tak boleh guna lah. Okay. Melainkan you buat dekat dalam poster platform and then you pastekan dekat dalam PowerPoint. Okay. Anything else you want to ask? Okay. So sebelum kita tutup, please what I can say, sign the attendant. Okay, fill up dekat Google Form. Okay, Google Form yang hari tu sama je. Maksudnya dekat kelas you ni Google Form adalah sama. Ya, ya, saya cari. Saya tak ada punya lagi. Okay. So, you fill up the attendance. Okay, and ada satu lagi yang I nak suruh you buat. Sekejap ya. Okay. So, sign attendance sebab I tengok hari tu ada yang banyak yang tak sign the attendance. And minta tolong you respond to this particular Google Doc. Okay, so you pergi kat link tu, you tolong jawab, okay, for that particular Google Doc. Okay, they are looking for this particular Wakaf Entrepreneurship, okay, response. Okay, yang lain, I rasa dah, okay. And start from next week, okay, I akan ask you lah about the understanding of chapter 6 to 8. So, make sure minggu depan, you dah boleh cover, kita dah boleh cover dah. Okay, all this particular chapters mengikut the lesson plan. Okay, 6 to 8, I akan mungkin do some what we so call as soal jawab lah. Okay, secara online. So, kalau macam ni semua off the audio. Okay, and next week bila I panggil, you have to on the audio. Okay, so that's all. See you next week. Okay, thank you for listening. Okay, and selamat berpuasa. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.